For men only, what are the most stressful things that you experienced when having a newborn for the first time? The first really stressful thing I remember was how totally unprepared I was for the drive home with our newborn. It wasn't something I considered as there was so much going on. It was fucking terrifying. I love my daughter, but for the first few months of her life, I was a wreck. I felt like I couldn't do anything right. I was working all day and then up for my wife feeding her at night. I remember standing in my kitchen sterilizing bottles at around 4 a.m. crying and just saying, I fucked my life. Everyone else seemed to be happy to be a dad, and I wasn't. I felt like I was being ungrateful and or unloving, and it caused all sorts of stress. Well, we just had my daughter today at 3:41. I'll check back in a few weeks. But I'm already wrapped around her little finger. The endless amount of visitors to the house, all with different opinions on what's best for mom and baby. Just when you think mom can get a snooze, which she absolutely needs, the doorbell goes. This led to sleep deprivation on top of her already being in a fragile mental state, eventually led to postpartum psychosis and a suicide attempt. I'm just an uncle, but I've been living with my sister, brother-in-law and soon to be 6-month-old. I take care of her 2 weeks a week by myself. The biggest challenge has been figuring out why she's crying. When it's food time, that's easy. But outside of that, what's up? Diaper is pretty easy to figure out too, but sometimes she's just tired and refuses to sleep unless she's held. Okay. But one time after picking up my little cousin from school, she was just screaming. We thought she was cold, but when I got her home, she was covered in sweat. Her jacket was making her way too warm. A month or two ago was the biggest wallet up. They went out for a party and maybe 10 minutes later she just started wailing. Went through the basics, she still wouldn't stop. Now she hyperventilating. Hacking. No temperature. We just cranked up the heat, maybe too dry? Humidifier doesn't help. After about an hour I'm getting super concerned. Have the phone in my hand to call her parents when I notice a hair on her lips. She was born with a full head of hair. I move it away and she instantly stops. She looks at me like, what the hell was that? Homegirl had a hairball. Slept like a rock the rest of the night. How I am going to afford all this? Most stress I had was due to everything. Just, everything was different. Everything was harder. A lot harder. On top of that, you have so many new tasks that you have to do. Then, when you feel overwhelmed and or incompetent, you feel guilty for feeling that way because your partner has it so much worse. Hard to overstate how inadequate you might feel. It's like a recipe for depression. Best hope you can avoid it, cause it makes everything like 10x worse and you likely won't find much sympathy support. It took quite a few months before I learned to enjoy parenthood, and some time after that before it basically became bliss on tap. Even when things are awesome, the depression might stick around. If it does, get help ASAP. Speaking from experience, depression is sticky. Ignoring it or just hoping things will get better probably isn't going to help. Aside from the actual birthing experience, for me, it was being gentle. Babies are so fragile and I don't know my own strength, so I was always worried about hurting them or dropping them. Just be extra careful and you'll be okay. Free tip: don't complain about changing diapers or feeding them. Your lady just pushed out a fleshy watermelon. That's the least you can do. My kid favored my wife over me at first and it just felt like I couldn't do anything right. Looking back on it, it was like, of course, she's the one he's known his whole life and I'm the new person. I think the hardest part was the pregnancy. My wife breezed through it meanwhile I was having panic attacks every time she went to an appointment and would regularly wake up in the middle of the night and sob uncontrollably at the thoughts of her dying in labor and me being alone taking care of a baby, or what if something happened to him and we lost him. My second child just started crawling. I was washing dishes and he very quickly crawled to the dog food bowl and crammed a mouthful of dog food into his mouth while my back was turned. He immediately started to choke, turned blue and limp while I did infant Heimlich on him. I was able to get it out, but to this day it shakes me to the core. That was 8 years ago, and to this day I still have anxiety about him eating certain foods. Sadly for us, the nurse shoved a bulb syringe into his mouth, pierced his throat, causing him to bleed into his stomach for his first night on his own. Next day they suctioned it out, it bled again, he puked what looked like a gallon of blood out, rushed him into an ICU, had to sign a bunch of papers releasing the hospital of liability in case he passed away, then staying there for 5 days with no definitive diagnosis of what was wrong. Poking him with needle after needle, listening to him scream, not knowing how to help, not being able to hold him because he was covered in wires and feeding tubes and IVs. Then driving him home for the first time, he was screaming. Having your first kid is hard. All you hope for is the baby and mom to be healthy, because it is a battle for both of them. But to have, I guess, an accident happen to your baby, not good. My experience was not like those TTs where everyone is all happy and glowing. Sorry, rant and painful memory over. Mike Birbiglia very well described it. I'm paraphrasing, but he says, I watched two incredible things happen. My daughter came into the world, and my wife became a mother. And I pretty much stayed the same. My kids are the most important people in my life. I love them more than anything. But there was not an instant moment of transcendental love and connection for me when they were first born. It came gradually, over months. And apparently that's not how it's supposed to happen. And nobody wants to talk about that. So yeah. That was stressful. Money. Having to cut my son's own AC off him after a blowout. The first few weeks were filled with so much sleep deprivation, arguments with SO, and an initial lack of bonding because baby was either latched to SO's nipple, screaming their head off, or sleeping for 20 to 30 minute intervals. It almost broke our relationship because we were both so overwhelmingly exhausted and at each other's throats because of the responsibilities with the baby, our work, yay USA's hatred for decent parental leave, and our house all conflicting with each other. Oh, and our social lives went out the window, despite some friends coming over to support, but eventually, that peters off because they realized we're not fun anymore now that we're sleep-deprived husks. All in all, it takes a hell of a lot of patience with each other, patience with the baby, sacrificing whatever schedule you used to have, and doing a ton of research on week 1 baby explications, week 2 baby milestones, week X what is normal about my baby, is this sound normal, my baby does this, is this normal, and on it goes. And don't even get me started on the never fucking ending washing of those damn plastic bottles and the myriad of accessories that go with them. I wish someone stopped me, looked me in the eye and said, you will sleep again. I promise. When the kid gets sick, you would give everything for them to get better. They eventually get better, but every child sickness used to be extremely scary for me at first. That's a good question. Those first few weeks feel like a blur. It's stressful, but there is something special about it. I think it was just figuring out how best to help. Mom is so important those first few weeks. I feel like once she was able to pump and I could help out with the night feedings, it felt so much better. Helping out your SO as well as connecting with the baby. It was like, okay, now we can get into a flow here. Still hard. But that made it easier. Having a newborn also just does strange things to time. Like I'd have to stop myself from rushing from one thing to another. There was really no reason. Just take a beat. Do the next right thing. After the actual birth, I was worried about SIDS. Set up fans near his crib, constantly checked on him. After about 9 months, I relaxed. Don't beat yourself up if you don't feel connected to the baby right away. I've talked to many dads and that can be a source of anxiety, i.e. what's wrong with me that this doesn't make me happy. Mothers connect much faster, which makes perfect sense. Cut yourself some slack. When that baby starts looking at you and smiling, it will be a labor of love, I promise.